appreciate it. I think a lot of people assume because my dad was a songwriter that I just like came out of the womb writing songs, you know? And that was not at all the case for me. It actually took me attending MTS University in Murfreesboro to even consider that idea. I was actually in school there studying sound engineering initially because I thought, well, I like music, but I've never picked up an instrument. I've never written a song, so I know I'm not a songwriter. And but what could I do in the music industry that I really enjoyed? So I was taking classes there, and eventually I got far along in it enough that I was offered some electives, and one of those was Songwriting 101. And I thought, well, that should be an easy A. You know, they're just going to teach us to write little songs for commercials and things. So the very first day I got into this class, our professor said, can you play your favorite song you've ever written? And I thought, I'm sorry, I thought you were going to teach us to do that. I must have signed up for the wrong class here, you know? And I, after having a hard, long think about my other options for electives, I thought, I'll stick with songwriting. And so I borrowed a guitar from my dad and learned enough chords to kind of fumble around and write a few songs, you know? And by the end of the class, I had written a couple songs that I thought were pretty decent songs. And so this song that I had written in the class, I decided I was going to do a little demo of it. And so I did that. I did a little demo of it, and then I sent it to the only song plugger that I knew and said, hey, here's a song. Feel free to use it in a TV show if you'd like, or a movie, you know. Just let me know. That's not how it works. You don't just send your songs into people and be like, feel free to use them for a TV show. So, you know, my life went on, and I carried on for a couple months and played a few little shows around town and whatnot. And a couple months later, I got an email from this guy. He said, we're going to use your song in a TV show called Heart of Dixie. And I was like, cool, this songwriting stuff is really easy. And I beginner's luck, you know. And so I got this song in a TV show, and so I thought, well, I better record a couple more songs, you know, and then I'll have like a little EP or something I can put together, and I can go play some shows. And one show led to another, and one song led to another, and 1 year went by, and another year went by, and another year went by. And I ended up just falling in love with writing songs and touring and doing this very thing. And especially during COVID, I was reminded so clearly that this is the thing that I really love to do. It's not just writing music and recording it, but it's taking these songs and playing them for people and telling them my story and talking to other people about their story and going home and writing something about that, you know? So for me, this is my life, you know, and I'm so grateful for this little song, because if it weren't for this song, I literally would not be standing here today doing this. So this song changed my life in a lot of ways. It's called Lonesome.
kids they're out on their own. This old house ain't much to look at. I can't put my finger on it. I don't know now who's to blame, but the one thing that I'm sure of is lonesome goes both ways. Take the pictures from Morocco. I'll take the postcard from a lane. All friends, they're gonna ask us, but all that we can say is that there's something ain't for certain. Some things never change, but the one thing you can count on is lonesome goes both ways. Oh,
thank you. I appreciate it. I'd like to welcome Gustav back up on stage. Wherever he is. There he is, Gustav.
Oh, howling bones, singing like the rain on old Black River. And don't you know, you don't shake no howling. Hammer down. away. The walls are closing in real fast. Oh, if I were you, I'd get to running.
Tonight, this has been such good fun. We'll play a few more for you. And...
I just got here.
Ten more.
Ten more, he says.
Twelve.
We'll be scraping the bottom of the barrel then at that point, I think.
Down to the covers.
That's what we want.
The bottom of the barrel. You want the bottom of the barrel. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just
down to after ski songs. Just
the all the Creedence.
Country road.
Freebird.
Yes, we'll be down to
Freebird. Freebird.
Oh, yes. Don't ruin it. I still like that song very much.
Wagon will be the last one.
As long as you play it.
Well, first, let's play all the happy songs. So I was sitting in a bar in my hometown. It was around Christmas time. And I had my pen and paper and was kind of trying to get some inspiration for a song. And the word gold rush kept coming to mind, and I wasn't really sure how to make that word fit in with what I had written. So I called my friend Ashley McBride, and I said, Ashley, I've got this song idea that I just can't seem to fit together the lyrics with the hook of the song. So we sat together, and we talked about this word gold rush, and we talked about how life can feel a little like the gold rush sometimes, because sometimes it can feel a little bit like the better part of your life has come and gone. And there are days that you feel that way because you've given so much of yourself to something or someone else, whether that be that you've given yourself to your dreams or to your job or to your family. I think we all sometimes feel like, you know, what do I have left for myself? Because I've given so much of myself to someone or something else. And so we started writing a song with that in mind. And, you know, the years come and go out of your life. And the people come and go out of your life. And for people like me and Ashley and Gus and anybody who does this for a living, the cities come and go. The crowds come and go, and you go out and sound check in some random city, in some random bar or venue, and you pour your guts out to a room full of mostly strangers, and then you pack it up and you go to the next city and do it again. And some days it can be the most rewarding thing in the world, like I talked about earlier, and some days you can think, man, what the hell am I doing with my life, you know? And so anyways, we wanted to write about all those things because I like to write about the hard stuff. I like to write about the stuff that maybe other people don't want to talk about, but that we all are sitting with, you know, in a room together. There are things that we don't want to talk about with each other, so important things, exactly. And for me, I would love whenever people leave my show that they know if there was one person in that room that felt like maybe they were alone, to know that they're not alone in the way that they feel, that maybe other people don't talk about the hard stuff in life, but that we all think about it. And so, anyways, the song was written about that, and ended up naming my second record after this song. It's called Gold Rush.
Well, I probably wouldn't have come back if my parents weren't around. 'Cause I hate the way my name falls so weightless in this town. I don't know if this is living or slow motion suicide, but there's something about Christmas that makes me blur the line. We all smuggle in our demons like strong out movie stars. We've all got a damn good reason to hide how old we are. All the disappear, come back to claim their debt. We hold on to our heartache like a noose around our necks. Go down there on Sunday if I'm not too far.